There was Leonardo da Vinci of Italy, Pablo Picasso of Spain, and there is Ibrahim Mahama of Ghana, West Africa. Welcome to Kara View channel. If this is your first time here, please subscribe and hit the notification bell to receive future updates from the channel. Thank you. Today, we are taking you to an unparalleled location in Tamale, the northern region of Ghana. The Red Clay. Red Clay is an art museum owned by renowned Ghanaian artist Ibrahim Mahama. Ibrahim Mahama is known for large-scale installations made from materials with particular significance to Ghana's past and present. His works have received massive recognition both nationally and internationally. In 2019, Mahama was named the 73rd most influential African by the African Report. He was one of six artists shortlisted in 2021, for the fourth plinth commissions in Trafalgar Square. Mahama was born in Tamale, Ghana in 1987. In 2010, he earned a BFA degree in painting from Kwame Nkrumah University of Science and Technology in Kumasi, Ghana. He earned an MFA degree in painting and sculpture from the same institution in 2013. In 2015, Mahama gained international attention when he used jute sacks to encase public structures in Athens for Documenta 14, and a long outdoor corridor in the Arsenale complex at the Venice Biennale. Ibrahim Mahama opened Red Clay Art Center in Tamale in the year 2020. The art center is located along the Nanton Road, about 20 minutes drive from Tamale main town. Red Clay provides free entry exhibit aimed at giving local art lovers access to view and experience contemporary art from all over the world. Amongst the public collection include non-orientable Nkanza and fragments art installations by Ibrahim Mahama himself. This young man under 40, won the prestigious Prince Claus Award raking in $1 million from his immersive art, non-orientable Nkanza. Ibrahim Mahama could have chosen to live his life in Europe where his art is better appreciated. But he opted to return to Tamale in northern Ghana, build the Savannah Center for Contemporary Art, SCCA, and Red Clay Art Studio to retool the thinking and imagination of underprivileged children through the power of what he calls experiential arts. Like many of Africans, Ibrahim has not had it all rosy. Despite his fame and enormous achievements, you'd be shocked to know banks refuse to give him loans. And that monstrous Ghanaian/African expression, the system is not making his work any easier. Ibrahim Mahama therefore identifies with the struggles of today's youth of Africa and has some words of encouragement. Another captivating series by Mahama is The Savannah and the Fantasy of an African Factory. In this installation, he repurposes industrial materials like railway sleepers, often found in construction sites. Through this series, Mahama questions the social and economic implications of globalization and its effects on the laboring class in Africa. One of the most impactful installations by Ibrahim Mahama is Freedom and Justice. This monumental piece was displayed at the 56th Venice Biennale in 2015. The artwork covered the exterior of the Ghanaian pavilion with jute sacks, serving as a powerful commentary on trade, migration, and the interconnectedness of nations. Ibrahim Mahama's work is deeply rooted in social and political contexts, reflecting his concerns about labor, globalization, and the complexities of contemporary Africa. His installations often require community engagement, where locals participate in stitching the sacks together. This collaboration echoes his emphasis on shared experiences and the power of collective action. Mahama's artworks have left an indelible mark on the art world. He has exhibited his creations at major art institutions and biennales around the globe.
So do you know something? So if during that time you are not a hard-working person, you can't buy this. Very expensive. Yes. So today look at it.
And all these are the same thing?
Yeah, the same thing. And then we have only this trunk.
Trunk?
Yes. For our grandmothers. So even to have this, unless you are in somebody. They used to keep clothes, everything during a year, and then every secret thing inside here.
Okay.
Yes, for their special occasion days. Yeah. You know this, but I carry on about our great chiefs in Gabon. So even some of them, they use it for war bases or bulletproof and then this thing. Yeah. And then we have this lamp, which is Atanimia. Yeah, all in this lamp. So the professors that we have today, some of them, they use this for studies in secondary school. Because during that time, before that this lantern is up here. Yeah. So they will put shea butter here and put and pass piece of cloth here and light it. This one reminds me and you that people suffer before. Yes. So the kids today, they must learn past those professors that they use this all in this year. Because the challenges that they were facing, the electricity challenges. Now it is available today. So this is money box for Ashanti people. Yeah, this is money box for Ashanti people. So this
so
is... It used to open. Yeah, this is the receipt for Gihos Paint Company. And then because of cleaning that place, so they start bending it. And then this is propeller engine, which is engine that I don't know how can I to compare like scenarios, like passion air,
and it makes a lot of noise.
Noise,
but you see this one?
Yeah, that is it.